So decision-making in different case scenarios is what I'm going to talk about today. So we're just going back from seeing all the cases and then why we are doing SFIOL. So basically, a perfect cataract surgery is when we implant a IOL in the capsular bag, but that really doesn't happen always, maybe due to some preoperative, perioperative, or intraoperative complications. So the other surgical options that are there with us are ACIOL, iris fixation IOL, and the SFIOL. ACIOL and iris fixation IOL do not go without any complications, like there are chances of corneal decompensation, uveitis, uveitic glaucoma, and cystoid macular edema. And the advantages of using a SFIOL is it has a better refractive rehabilitation by placing the IOL. It is almost as close as possible to the actual location of the capsular bag. And the pupillary dilatation is unhindered. And untoward events like corneal decompensation, pupillary block, angle closure, or ocular inflammation is much less as compared to the other procedures. So three questions of what IOL we use or what procedure we use depends upon these three questions. First, are the haptics remaining within the eye or they're being externalized? If you want to leave the haptics inside the eye, then obviously you have to use sutures. If you intend to fix by achieving using sutures or you want a sutureless technique, depends upon how the surgeon is comfortable with, or you are using a single piece or the three-piece IOL. While using a three-piece IOL, whether it's a rigid or a foldable IOL, you can externalize haptics and do a glued IOL. Sutured SFIOL has certain disadvantages in the long run, like it causes post-operative inflammation, might cause suture erosion, suture breakage, and induced astigmatism. So I'll move through certain case scenarios. My first is a case of trauma, wherein, as you see, there is a rupture of the anterior capsule over here. The surgeon tries to do a phaco in this case, does a rexus, but the rexus margin gets extended over here. Now does a minimal hydrodissection. The cortical matters are quite soft and the nucleus is quite soft also. Tries to do a phaco and tries to rotate the lens, but rotation becomes a bit difficult, and you can see over here the rexus that had extended extends even further. Now he tries to rotate it again and tries to complete the phaco, but the nucleus, I mean, does not rotate that easily. So when he comes out, now you can see the nucleus, it goes down. So there is this part, the rexus probably has extended. Put some visco and tries to rotate it, tries to do a phaco then also, but he finds out there is a dialysis over here. He does some amount of anterior vitrectomy over there, tries to do, again try it, but the dialysis is again moved further, there is some drop, and he abandons it over here, and then takes it out, extends the wound margin, does the SICS, and sends it for a SFIOL. The second is an intraocular foreign body. There is a rupture of the capsule over here. As you can see, there is an intraocular foreign body embedded over here, and there is one more in the posterior chamber. The only way to go about this is obviously do a pars plana lensectomy, take out the intraocular lens, and do a vitrectomy, take out the posterior intraocular lens as well. We have taken out the intraocular lens through this extended corneal wound, and then do a secondary SFIOL or SFIOL in the same sitting. Now this was a case, 86-year-old male who came with sudden loss of vision and raised intraocular pressure. When seen, the patient was aphakic, and you see in the posterior chamber there is a dislocated lens. The next is a Marfan syndrome. In cases of Marfan syndrome, spherophakias, or in Ehlers-Danlos syndromes, all these cases they have got weak genules and there is a subluxation of the lens.
The picture isn't showing. Okay.
So, as you can see over here, there is complete genular dialysis over, and there's some amount of subluxation in this. So a PPL is done and a SFIOL is implanted. This was a case who presented 10 years after the surgery, had a very perfect vision, sudden loss of vision. As you can see, there is complete subluxation of the IOL along with the capsular bag. How to go about these cases? Either you can suture these the bag completely to the both the sides of the sclera, or else you can take out the haptic corneal bag complex and then put a secondary SFIOL. The next is a subluxated lens. Again, the haptic is seen over here. Such a case, you have to do a SFIOL. The next is a grade 4 cataract in an old man, 86-year-old male, with pseudo exfoliation. As it is in pseudo exfoliation, the junules are weak. The surgeon chose, had to put a toric lens. So these are the toric markers that he's putting. Did a good Rexis, tried to rotate the lens, and tried with the phaco. It was a very hard nucleus. He's saying that there's already a jugular dialysis at that point. He puts some visco and tries further, but he's unable to do so. He tries to see how much is the jugular dialysis. Then he knows that he cannot do it. Does a extensive own, does a SICS, the whole nucleus along with the bag comes out, and he's referred for SFIOL. This is a similar case as shown by Dr. Aswin previously. So this was an IOL where both the haptics, a three-piece IOL, both the haptics are there in the AC. So we tried to put the visco, try to loosen these haptics from either end. Either this haptics could have been tucked into the and done a SFIOL, but the surgeon here did not prefer to do that. Cut the optics and have retrieved the whole IOL and was sent for a secondary IOL, SFIOL. Next is, I want to tell you that the instruments used are basically the same as we use for a cataract surgery, except that you need two SFIOL forceps and the glue. So this was a case, old case where a glued IOL was done. That is why we have got all the superior rectus. Otherwise, the flaps are made with the ordinary the cataract instruments that we need, and require a basic vitrectomy to be done. If in case the cortex or the cortical matter are back, then you need to do a vitrectomy or a vitreous that is lying. As I'm a posterior segment surgeon, probably I always do I secure with this trochar cannulas and do a bit of a posterior vitrectomy and then insert my SFIOL. The basic steps are same as previously told by my previous speaker, so I'll just skip these videos. The IOL is either a foldable IOL or a rigid IOL. It depends upon what IOL you're doing. Therefore, the tunnels has to be accordingly. Many do a handsec technique. If you're doing a handsec technique, probably these two ports are required. If you don't do a handsec technique, the ports may not be required. So this is a foldable IOL, which can be entered through a 2.2 incision, and with the SFIOL forceps, you catch hold of the haptics and externalize it and tuck it. So these are basically the instruments, the two instruments that you require more beyond the cataract and the basic vitrectomy instruments are the SFIOL forceps and the glue. So these are the two instruments that you, things that you require in extra. So a word about fibrin glue. The two main components they are the natural occurring in the blood, that is fibrinogen and thrombin. Fibrinogen in the place of thrombin gives rise to fibrin, and thrombin in the glue also reacts with the fibrinogen of the host tissue to cause early fibrosis. That is why we use a fibrin glue. That is all I have to tell you. Thank you. We can proceed to our next speaker.
Yeah. So that was really nice. So basically what I want you all to carry home is for doing a glue dial, you really don't need too much extra. You just need the two glue dial forceps and a standby three-piece IOL. Maybe you can, the ones we have in the market, I don't have any financial interest, but if you want, I can suggest the kinds. And you obviously need a good vitrectomy unit and fibrin glue. In contradiction to the ongoing session, in case you don't have fibrin glue, there are various other options. But don't lose heart if you don't have fibrin glue. There are other means by which you can still fix the IOL. And any questions?
Yeah, fibrin glue is available by which company? Fibrin
glue. We use the Baxter's. We use the Baxter's. There are the Reliance also group has fibrin glue, but we use the Baxter's. It's the same, sir. It's the same. Just because we are using it for this surgery, we are calling it glue dial for. Yes, sir. No, we need the McPherson, standard McPherson's. That's part of. That's in my next topics. I'll be covering that. So basically, don't get disheartened if you don't have Baxter's glue at your disposal. There are various other means. We can come to those means at the end of the session. So I'll be taking over the next topic.